It's not hard to ask. We can evangelize just as we walk day to day. Cecilia mentioned, and I know she worked in the workplace for a long time consistently at the same place. There are people there that are watching you. There are people there that have needs, and you can do that without, you know, just banging the Bible and putting, being unseemly about it, you know, scaring people off. What is that? And praying in the corner. I've seen that. But that's not necessary. You can't evangelize. You can actually walk out what you profess and confess. So I encourage you to do those things. And so that is why I think the other Sunday, I don't know what was going on in the kitchen, but the kids were going at it. And I know they think that Sister Deborah's about crazy. I was yelling and screaming, but they are my, I feel that's my responsibility to check them and to get that in order. I know their parents didn't know what was going on. And so we're not to just look away and to step aside. That's kind of what's wrong today. We it's the end times, and each generation gets wickeder and wiser, and technology and all the things that are also progressing expose them to so many things, even when we don't expose them in our household. They are getting exposed to things, and I heard a message that the true test is not that they are so good and that we have done such a good job with them while they're at the house. Tell them clean up their room, they clean up the room. You know, you give them chores and all that's taken care of. The problem is when they go to kindergarten, first grade, and I'm going down to kindergarten. My sister is a teacher, and she got a first little class, and she was just at awe. She came home telling this story about some little girl, and she had tried to discipline her or have her sit down or whatever, and she put her hand on her hip and she started shaking her head. And she was going to tell her mama, and you can't tell me, and you ain't going to, and she was like, I don't even know what to do with that. She's fine, and you can't touch them. What do you do with that? And tell her to sit down, and it obviously didn't work, so put her in the corner or whatever, or time out. Didn't work, but that's what we're confronting, and that's where the true test of what we're doing is shown. Having once they get into kindergarten, first grade, because what we didn't teach them, somebody else is.
That's right.
Those little children it's almost scary. The things that you see and you hear, even tweens and young adults that come to the house, they might come with that rag on their head and their pants hanging down, but by the time they check us out, and Brother Beauty don't leave the living room or the den, and all y'all sitting around watching TV together, what is that about? They either don't come back, or when they come back, they pull them up, take the rag off, and they speak when they come in the door. You know, you just command the presence and there's a certain air that they know, oh, this is not like what I'm used to. And again, some don't ever come back, and some just come in and, well, you know, you got to keep the refrigerator a little fuller and the cabinets a little more things in the cabinet for them, because you want to have that influence on those young people. Again, we're experiencing perilous times. Pastors told us about that. These last days are now. 2 Timothy 3, 1 through 5, some of the scripture that talks about perilous times. And I can't tell you step by step what's going to come and what the different phases are that pastor can enumerate and describe in real detail. I can't describe the seven churches and all that right now. I understand it when I read it and when he's presented it to me, but I do know that the end times are now. The word is true, and it is being manifested today. And the thing I take away from that is I need to be ready. We need to be ready. I think that's the point. And one time I was like, oh, I feel like I'm an F because I can't remember it. But God, I don't know if it's age or you remember things and you go over it enough, you can get that. He taught us that repetition is the thing that makes things stick. But I began to feel inept about it, but I had to figure out, okay, so what does all that mean? And to me, that means I need to be ready. The time is now, and I need to be ready. And he soon got to that. This is why I'm teaching you. I do not want you to be asleep. I do not want Jesus to come unaware. When Jesus comes for his bridegroom, when the bridegroom comes for his bride, I want to be ready. 2 Timothy 3:1-5. He's talking about this. Know also that in the last days perilous times shall come. For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful. I pay attention where I work at PSO in the general office downtown. And across the street, it's not First Pres, but it's, I can't think what the big church is, and they have the feeding, and they feed in the morning, and give out groceries and clothes, and I have never seen, there are people that need, but so, you can see those then that are unthankful. Stuff being strolled all down the street, saying that that wasn't really what they wanted. I already got some too much from, taking, being provided for through the different agencies, but unthankful. We see it today. Unholy, oh my God. I don't like to talk about goals and all that kind of stuff. Yeah, that's what everybody should, I'm okay with. That does not speak to who you are. I do know that. However, I'm not seeing so much nakedness in all my life. I'm not talking about being comfortable. I'm talking about, I have a granddaughter, she's 9. My stepson's daughter, 9. I thought I would help with school clothes. And I couldn't find no jeans that came all the way to the waist for the girl. I started digging around in the boys' apartment. What's up with that? They her little behind is out. I'm so embarrassed for her. She hadn't figured out she's cute yet, so she didn't have a need for that, and I just wanted a t-shirt. So, some stuff was cute, and that's kind of cute, but, I didn't want somebody looking at her because, there's so much sin, somebody has a fascination with that. I didn't need a tiny tee. I didn't need a tight tee. And all these, they got a little dents on their little waist. They got a little waist. It was just bothering me. And she kept saying, Oma, what's the matter? I just struggled. So this, today, unholy, just unholy. And again, there's so much. You're just exposed to so many things. I used to enjoy glee. And now they've sexualized that. I mean, everything is turning. You need to pay attention to children's shows. There's that undercurrent of something sexual. And some of the Disney movies anymore, they're adults. These kids have no clue. They're watching the penguins and whatever it is, but it is more for a teenager. My daughter, who is 30, the baby is, that's what she loves all the animation. It's adult stuff. You need to pay attention. Everything is not for our children. We need to be careful. This is an unholy time. It's an unholy time. Everything's acceptable. We've allowed everything to be acceptable, to say anything you want to say, all these liberties we have, and to do anything we want to do. And, you know, it's a big title, HR consultant, but just being in hiring and firing business, young people are coming through, another generation are coming through, but have no communication skills. You know, they don't know how to represent themselves. You come into an interview and you have to turn away. I'm female, I have to turn away because when they sit down, you know, I see the top of that. Thank you. I think that's okay, whatever floats your boat. I'm just saying, they don't even know how to represent them. So we've allowed anything to be okay.